Hello, it's Keith from KMAs Korner. How are you doing today? I'm on the Serenity network again, or Serenity server. I don't know why I called it a network. It might be a network, but it's just called the Serenity server. Let me get rid of my mustache. Mustache, no mustache. I'm easily distracted at this time of day, so excuse my insolence. I am in the process of gathering supplies for my extremely long nether tunnel and mustache. Because of this extremely long tunnel, I've had a love-hate relationship with this server. To refresh your memory, the nether tunnel is, probably 1,300 blocks long. And it is a complicated design, and I bit off more than I can chew. But I don't like biting off more than I can chew. It gives me the challenge to complete it, but it's kind of given me this impeding feeling of doom when I think of Serenity, because I know I have to do this god-awful tunnel. And it's going to take a lot of work, and I've been kind of like, oh my god, Serenity. And it has nothing to do with the server itself, it has to do with the project on the server. So if you have ever heard me dog this place, it's not because of the server, it's because of what I have chosen to do on the server. So, if you haven't seen any of the other videos, nummy num num num. I really gotta get some sort of other food source. But if you haven't seen any of my other Serenity videos, the tunnel is, a lot of it is this stuff. And I've learned over the years that the best way to get this stuff, instead of taking that stuff and smelting it, because you need four for each single bar, you just take a fortress and tear it down. One thing that's interesting with fortresses is where they used to be, withers and stuff like that still spawn. So even though there's no netherrack and stuff right here, you will get blazes, you will get wither skeletons, and other stuff spawn down here, so be careful. You may even want to mark off the territory of where the fortress was that you took down to get these blocks. But let me show you real quick what level I'm at on my tunnel. I've got most of the floor laid out and track laid out most of the way, except for that was a waste of time, because anytime I walk down the tunnel, a gas comes and blows up my track. So the faster I can get walls on this thing, the better it's going to be for me. All right, so this is what the tunnel looks like from the outside, complete, other than this little hole here. And basically, for the whole stretch where there is openness around me, the whole stretch I have this middle lane done the whole way without tracks. The tracks are done about 80% of the way. I have this done on the open areas and most of the closed areas. And when I mean closed areas, I mean areas like this. I've broadened it up to 3 wide and added this on each side, and that is for a good 80%, maybe 90% actually, of the track. And now I'm laying this row on the side where the glass goes down, so I can put the glass up and protect myself from gas. So that's what I'm doing. I have in the open areas about 70% of this done, and in the closed areas, 0% of it done. So that's the level I'm at. And basically, before this episode is done, I want to have the bottom all laid out and the glass on the sides, and a single block, probably that block right there, marking out every one of these structures. Then in the future, I will work on the structures, because I just want to be able to use the track and get back and forth. Because I still got to lay three more rows, the whole 1,300 blocks, so that's like 4,000 blocks right there of this. Then work on each one of these pillars to hold up the whole structure. I have a ton of glass, but I still got to go get some more sand. And maybe we should do that now. Good thing to know, nobody has messed with any of my stuff since I've left, which is pretty awesome. I guess I could go to sleep. Make it day. It's nice to be able to play with my old Sky again. I've been playing on Athens MC, which is doing 1.9 right now, and none of the modifications to the resource pack that I have done can't exist because none of the resource packs are updated for 1.9 that I know of right now, and that's fine. Oh, I don't even have a bed up here. How interesting. Made a new sand pit to get my sand for my glass, because I'm gonna have four rows of glass going the 1300 blocks. I'm guessing that it's 1300 blocks, to tell you the truth. It's been a little while since I've been on the server, so I don't know the exact number, but if I remember right, one tunnel goes 700 blocks and the second tunnel goes about 600, so it's a long way. Need to make sure I have enough glass. It's all going to be red, which is pretty easy to make. Seeing we have skelly spawners, we have unlimited access to bone meal, so I can just, you know, bone meal the two tall red flowers and get red glass, or red dye to make red glass. So it's not a big deal to making red glass. If it was blue, it might be a little different. And unfortunately, the blue is what I like to do. So I haven't told you what we're actually doing in this episode, but I said I was going to do this in the very first episode, and it's episode 7 or 8, and I have yet to make it. And that is the flower farm. That is our goal today. And after I collect some sand and start it cooking, so I have plenty of sand to... Oh, better stop. Inventory space is null. We can get rid of the glass. All right. Let's jump this popsicle joint. I don't even know what I'm talking about now. So, I made this very ugly pillar. It's a good way to point out where your sand is going to be. You do want to do a place that is far away from anything that you're going to be going to if you want to make a sand pit. And my pagoda is just actually kind of too close to the sand pit, but I don't see myself doing anything in this desert. But I think it's right over there. It should be coming into view in a second. And if you hadn't noticed, let me eat up yum yum, which takes forever right now. Another issue on Serenity I gotta take care of is a better food source. I save that every video and I still don't do it. What the? Oh, that's a horse. Like, what the hell was that? So, someplace out here, I'm gonna make some flower farms. Maybe like right around here. Depends on what type of flowers show up. I wanna make sure I get most of the flowers in the flower farm. So I gotta do some bone mealing to find out what flowers show up where, because Basically, if this flower shows up on this block every single time I bone mail, I'll either get some grass or that particular flower. So I want a structure where I can get most of the flowers that people will use to get all the correct dyes and stuff. So that is our goal. I'm pretty sure these are pretty easy to make. I've never made one in my life, so this is going to be an experience for me. But I'm going to get the sand in the furnaces. I'm going to my spider farm because it has the most and bestest furnaces, and it's kind of more my home base than my pagoda. Did I just see something down here? It could have been just artifacts from my watermelon. I hear the spiders running around, having fun and stuff. How dare they? They're like, yeah, I'm in a good mood. I'm just going to let you despawn instead of kill you. Ooh, look at this. I got some stuff. So I am going to go and work on the flower farm and probably show it to you when it's done, because I'm going to be following a tutorial. And I threw my sword. Good thing I noticed. And because I've never made one of these before. I'm pretty sure I have a bunch of glass somewhere already, but I'm going to need thousands of blocks of glass. So thankfully, I can make them into panes. But enough of the jibber-jabbing. I'll be back. All right. I have done some work. I'm underneath the flower farm. And here's a dispenser with the bone meal. And a little timer, or delay, that goes up to the surface, powers this torch, and allows the ethohopper timer thingy to work. And what happens is it sets this dispenser off that's over here. Oh, actually, I don't need this right here. And sets water to go. So the bone meal goes, the water comes, swipes it all into that. Then we have our output chest right there. Unfortunately, I was trying to get three types of flowers in this little bunch. The white ones, orange ones, red ones, and the pink ones, the tulips. But all I got are white and one spot for orange. So this is basically a lot of stuff for just white flowers. I'm not too happy with this farm at all. Well, let's see it at work, okay? The water goes, I got one flower, just shoots, then I got two more flowers, yay. Then water goes away, and it shoots again. No flowers. Okay. Well, I wonder why there is a flower there. But anyways, it works. The productivity isn't where I would want it to be. And the fact that I only have two different types of flowers here, and I'm looking to get like 8, maybe 10 different flowers in a flower farm, is kind of a fail. The design works great, but it's really hard to get more than one or two flowers here. So I can see doing this in a swamp biome to get that one type of flower in the swamp. But I want some of those purple ones, and I want, you know, some of the red ones, and some of the lap, whatever those things are called. I'm not a big flower guy. Plus, it is very laggy, because the clock is only 3 things long. So I really don't suggest you use this on a server. For my purpose, I'm going to get it so I can get that one last flower. There we go. For my purpose, this is kind of a fail. It looks ugly too. Seeing I hadn't made one of these before, I kind of made a mock-up one. So I may tear this whole thing down. Or I just may replace the cobble with probably the diorite. That's what I'll probably end up doing, is just replacing the cobble with the diorite. Keeping this, making one right next to this one over here so I can get the red and orange ones better. Then maybe making one over here on this side where this tree is so I can get the pink ones. And that will settle my tulip frenzy, even though I said this is not nearly as good as I was expecting it to be. What a sunset. Time to take a nap. KMA's Korner, join the game. Twice! Yeah, sometimes when I plug my mic in, if the game's already running, it's not... I'm not going to hear the game through my headphones, so I gotta, you know, restart Minecraft with the game set up for a recording. The more you need to know. So, yeah, this was kind of a fail, or not what I wanted. The last thing I really wanted to do was put four or five of these farms in front of my pagoda and ruining the beauty of this forest. So I don't know. I haven't decided what I'm going to do. But I did... Where did I put it? I think it's up here. Hello, Zisto. Excuse you. I did make a trade with somebody. Because I am suffering so badly with food and kind of regret having my storage way up here, but where is it? Right here. I got some eggs. You know what that means. It's time to build a chicken cooker. Gotta have my fire resistance potions, because why? When you're out here and you're laying brick over lava and you happen to fall off like an idiot because your wife comes and starts talking to you and you're not paying attention, when you have your fire resist potion and you're not wearing really any armor, you can still survive falling into the lava. I fell into the lava over near that lava fall. And by the time the potion was drank, thankfully, it was... No, actually, it wasn't on my bar, but I pulled it out, and I drank it, and I had half a heart. And as soon as I jumped out of the lava, a gas started trying to kill me. So when you're doing this work in the Nether, never not be prepared, because stuff happens. And if you want to protect yourself from unnecessary deaths, make sure you use, or you at least have a fire resist potion on you when you go to the Nether. Minecraft 101. There's some interesting facilities out here I've been noticing that have popped up since the last time I've been out here. That was a nice building in the distance. I haven't investigated that to see whom is building this. Pop filter probably didn't work too well on that whom. And there's another building, I think, yeah, over there. See on the corner of my... That looks really interesting on the right side over there. If I look right at it, I can't see it. But I go like this, I can see it. So I've been laying this every time I go into town, laying another thing on my Nether tunnel. Next, I'm gonna do is, there's a power track. I made the whole, where are you? Oh, there you are. Well, I can't actually see you, jerk. I can just see your fireballs. Now I can see you. If, serves you right. Another one. Serves you right. Every gap here is for a power rail. And halfway between is going to be another structure. You saw at the beginning of the nether tunnel, it's been probably a little while, but every 8 blocks there's a support. And after I get this down, I'm going to mark out where the supports are. Then I'm going to start laying the glass in between so I don't have to really worry. There'll be a hole on top, but most of the time when I'm running through here, I will be unseen and things will not attack me while I'm doing what I was just doing. As you saw, gas are very plentiful around here. So, gotta protect my track. Another step. I mean, this thing will be done maybe before I die. I don't know. It's a lot longer than I would like. So, I'm gonna put down some more of this nether brick, I guess. And I'll be back with another update. Another thing I have changed. Before, I had blocked my entrance to my place, and I covered it up with nether brick here, but I said, I've marked it, and I've warned people how long it is right now. I, on my other server, saw the owner and one of his good friends have a secret nether tunnel, and I kind of felt left out. I'm like, what, am I not good enough to see your secret place? And I felt bad, even though there was really nothing for me to feel bad about. So I decided that I'm not going to keep anything secret. So anywhere I'm going, I'm going to make sure everybody knows. Because I showed a couple of people that secret, but why am I hiding? It's not like my place is a secret or anything. So I decided, even though it's not done, I'm gonna let people see the unfinished tunnel and whatever, because it's gonna take so long. This is the chicken cooker at spawn that I think has failed miserably. And I don't know if it's because of the redstone or what's going on with it, but I'm hoping when I make mine that mine's gonna work and it's not a redstone issue with the server. And for your knowledge, I have resupplied a lot of the wool in here. So have at it. Enjoy. Haven't sold anything since last night. The only one I'm having trouble with right now is black, which is a good color to have troubles with. So there's plenty here. And so come and get it. Don't forget to donate. All right. I am working on a little project. This guy doesn't have to live anymore. Sorry, dude. I'm gonna steal your eggs. Yeah, baby. No, all those eggs just did not come from that one chicken. I mentioned earlier I made a trade with somebody. Let's see if I got some dirt to fill in that hole. I guess not. It's no biggie, I got some dirt down here. Because I was going to use that chicken to wherever he was. He's right there. I was going to use that chicken to supply me with eggs, but yeah. It doesn't happen. Even with almost 100 hours on this server, that chicken has given me a total, stop it, of only a couple of eggs. But yeah, I usually like to have 40 something chickens in here, and it's looking like I'm gonna have like 10, which is not cool. Because I've been on, like I said, I've been on the server for almost 100 hours, and all I've eaten is watermelon. And yeah, I mean, come on. Yummy, watery. Yummy is good, but watery is not. And I'm so sick of having to walk 20 feet and taking another watermelon. So I'm trying to fix this situation, and I don't have enough chickens. We got about 12 in there. I paid, well, I overpaid because I was being nice, like I always do, but I paid 9 diamonds for those 12 chickens. That's almost a diamond per chicken. I should just read some of these up right now before I close this all up. Oh, wait, they're not even old enough to breed. Shit. Yeah, so I'm hoping that with this replaced, it's going to look a little bit better, more in line with the pagoda. So I like my pagoda, but I'm not liking the look of cobble out here, because it doesn't match with anything. I'm just trying to make sure I'm not really destroying anything with redstone without taking notice first. So this one has a redstone dust. Stop. There we go. This one has a redstone dust. Like that. This one's just got a torch. And this one is just there for looks. Where's my torches? Redstone torch. Then I'm going to replace these three, because they are seen from the outside. And let's see if this looks better. Probably. Does it still work? Let me see. Yeah. I mean, it's a good way to get orange and white. Oh. The key is to turn it off when the dispenser isn't dispensed with water. So, yeah, that looks 10 times better. So I'm kind of happy with this. Next episode, I will probably already have made 2 more next to each other to get all the tulips that I need. And then I gotta figure out how to get this stuff and the other flowers and the biome. I love it when I try and hit my F5 key and instead I hit my record key. So, basically, we're gonna have 3 flower farms here and maybe one over there for use limited. Don't worry, Hal. I'm not gonna, like, leave them running so I get stacks and stacks of flowers. I just want some extra flowers. Just, I don't know. My wife asked me, why do you make these things if you don't really care? She's like, do you need flowers? I'm like, no, not really. She's like, well, why are you making these things? And I go, well, you know, it's kind of fun doing this stuff. I'm playing. You know, playing is for fun. So making something like this, even though it's not nearly as grand as I thought it was going to be, it is fun. So I enjoy it. Yes, I do. I enjoy. But this episode is done. I hope you welcome me back to the Serenity server. It's been a little while. I'll continue making videos on here. And next episode, I don't know what we have in mind. But the flower farm will be expanded by then. And I will show you some results. Probably some more work on the nether. And maybe to beautify some stuff up. Because I've noticed in all my worlds, I tend to make all these projects and then I don't make them look good. So I will focus on trying to make some things look better. But until next time, have a good day. It's Keith from KMAs Korner on the Serenity server. Come say hi, link in the description down below to get on the server, and let me punch you. Because that's what I do with the people who join servers because of my videos. I find them and I punch them. Just ask some people. Have a good day. Bye-bye.